See, if you have already the assembly file here, so you can remove this file. How you can remove this file in the sense? See, just click on it, right click on that, remove file. Okay. If you do that, just click it. Okay. So you'll be removing that particular assembly file. Okay. So to your target, okay, to your project, so you can add the new file. Okay. That is already your project supported by some controller, 8051 controller. So now you are going to add new file to your project. So simply you just create a new file. Okay. So you save this file by using some name, whatever the name you want. For example, I'm going to write my first C program. My first dot C program. Okay. So I'm going to write my, so the extension should be dot C for C language. If you're going to write the program in C language. Okay. Save the file. So here this file has to be added to the target. So click on the source group. Okay. Right click, add to the group. Okay. Add to the source group one. So it will show the one tab. You here you can type you, which is your file, first.c. Okay, if you add, so that here you can see that your file is added. After giving add, your file is added here. Okay. So now you can close the thing. So here you can stop typing your C code. Okay. So here I'm going to write my first program, that is, so write a program to send hexadecimal value. Okay. So I'm going to send hexadecimal value, starts from the value 00H2FF. Right. So I'm going to send this value, okay, to, that is the value is 002FF. Okay. So where I want to send? So I'm going to send it to the port one. I'm going to send to the port one now. So how does it look? See, I have a controller here. So I have 8051 controller. Okay. So 8051 controller. So here I have, let me assume this is my port one. Okay. So we have port 0, port 1, port 2, and port 3. So this port one is 8-bit port. That is, it has 8 pins. It has 8 pins. Okay. So it has 8 pins. So that is, since it is a 8-bit port, so if you provide 00, all 8 lines will be low signal. That is zero potential. Zero potential if the value is 00. If you provide FF, say like, so 5 volt will be across the all pin if you provide FF. Okay. So that here externally you can interface any LED or any other output device where you can interface with each and every particular pin, so that you can control each and every LEDs across the 8051, like, for example, traffic light control and all, you can do this. Okay. Okay. So now I'm going to send this, how I'm going to design my program, right? So initially always the C program starts with the header file, right? So I just use header file asterisk include So here it is not stdio. So here you should use reg51.h. So this is the header file, which is supported by the controller, 8051 controller. Now, for example, in your program, if you are using port 1, I'm going to use this port 1 is related to 8051. Okay, so this has to be supported. Okay, this has to be supported so that the header file will support if you use this particular P1 or P0, so which are all belongs to the registers of 8051. Okay. Okay, right. Some of the supported ports, peripherals, registers. So that for that you should use this particular header file. So this header file will support that. Okay. Now, so I'm going to have my main function. So I use void main void. Okay. I just open the body of the program. Okay. So here, what is this void? Anybody knows that? What is this? Why we use void here? Return type is null. Okay. So for that, here in this main within the main program, we don't need to use return type. Okay. Return, that is we are trying to return some numeric value. No. So if you use void, it is null. So even this is a function which is sending some variable to the some other function. No, it is void. Null we are sending. Okay, right. So this is the body of the program. So here I'm going to use my a variable. So which I am going to send it to the port one, right? So what is the variable I can use? So in default, it will take signed character. So here I don't want signed character. I'm using only unsigned. So I can use unsigned character. What is the variable name you want to mention? So I try to mention some variable z. Okay. Z. This is the variable I'm going to use. So here the hexadecimal value 00 to FF, this one I want to send it to port 1. So I want to send it to port 1, that is hexadecimal from 00 to FF. So in this variable, I'm going to keep that 00 to FF, continuously increment that. So continuously that variable I want to put into port 1. Okay, for this, so what is the loop I want to use? So I can use for loop. So designed variable z equal to, just initializing it is zero because the value starts from zero, semicolon, the condition z is less than equal to 255, the increment z plus plus. So you can have a body of the for loop is okay. So this is the value. See, what is the value in terms of decimal? Zero is zero. I have mentioned here in decimal. Right, equivalent decimal value for FF, the maximum value is 255. That is the value I mentioned. Now, the Z value will be zero here for the first iteration. So next it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 till 255. Okay. So since port 1 is, what is the port 1? So port 1 is... port 1 is 8-bit port. 8-bit port. So whatever the value here, that will be displayed in 8-bit value. Okay, 8-bit value. So 255 will be displayed as 8-bit value. That will be like all one, right? So anybody having doubt here? Simple program. That's it, the program. We just compile this, right? We'll try to run the program here. So I'll go to, just close assembly. So I'll close. This is my program. So I don't want memory window and all. Okay, simply I want only the port one to see my output. Okay, so in port one, you can see this, it will vary from 00 to FF. If you want, I will run the program. Okay, the program is running now. So for example, if you want to see very slowly, so you can add some delay here for every thing. So you can simply add one more delay. I'll use some unsigned in time use. So since you want to see, I'm just going to use more than 255 value. So I use a character A. So this is my character A. I just initialize A equal to 0. A is less than equal to some, I'm going to use 50,000 as my delay. A++. Close it, finish the for loop. So if you want, you can use number of times this and check out. Undo here. Okay, number of times you can use and check out how slowly the increment happens. That is how the value is put across the port one. I just run the program. There is a syntax error here. Okay, so here it should be semicolon. Okay, I will build the program now. It is coming without error. Just build the, debug the program. Just take the port one, go to peripheral, go to input output port. From that, take peripheral one, that is port one. Run the program. So here you can see that in slow that the values are incremented from 00 to, it will be incremented till FF. Okay. So any doubt, very simple program. So this, everything is for just a delay. Okay. It is a delay for to visualize how the increment happens. See here, 0 initially, we are putting 0 to port 1. Next iteration, putting 1 to port 1. So like that, till 255, that is till FF. So, right. Okay. So, any doubt here? Students can ask me. So any doubt, see same program. So you can see in the PPT also, I will share the PPT, so which is already taken. Okay. Here. Okay. See, same program. See, we are using header file. We are using main file. So we are going to use a simple character. So to take this value as an input value. So this value we are going to use into a for loop to iterate number of times to increment from 00 to FF. So that value we are pushing into port 1. Okay. Every time, that is until 255, data will be pushed. And you can add some for loop for delay, small delay. Okay. To visualize how the increment happens. Right? Any doubt here? So next we will see. Okay. So here, next program. So write a program to send a value. I'll just put program to send values of minus 4 to plus 4. Plus 4 to same port 1 I'm going to use. Okay. Okay. So here I will explain. See, in so if you are working in signed numbers, okay, signed numbers. So we have in decimal value ranges from that is from minus 128 to plus 127. Okay, so here these values will take only 7 bits is more enough. And this minus sign will have 1 bit. That is most significant bit. So combinedly, it forms a 8 bit. The equivalent hexadecimal value is 80H. The equivalent hexadecimal value. That is, in order to store this value in 8-bit value, the value is, that is 100. This is 1 for negative number. The 128 will be written as 000, like this. Okay. See, for the count will be like 0 plus 1, 0, 1, in hexadecimal 0, 1, 2, 3. So till 7F, 7F seems to be the binary value is like this. The decimal value is like this. So after that, 80 is your minus 128. That is FF is nothing but your minus 1. Okay, this is a point you must know, right? So now I'm going to display. So here I'm going to use signed character. Okay, signed character. We are going to take an example of signed character since we have used the plus and minus values. Right, plus and minus values. Okay, so here I will we will work out on the software so that one by one I will try to explain. See, I'll just remove this. I think I have shared the software now, right? Okay, so we are going to see the program is, so this is right, we are trying to send a value minus 4 to, that is plus 4. you can see equivalent 8-bit value in the port 1 now. Okay. So for that, so what is the initial? So we have to take a header file now. We're going to use a header file. Simple header file. So any global variable required, no need. Just I'm going to create a simple main function, open braces, and I'm going to use close braces. This is the body of the main program. So now, what is the, I'm going to use the array, right? So array character, assigned array, all right? The array name is here, minum. Minum is the variable. So if you want, I think students are aware of this, right? So array and all, I think you know, right? So I have given the array of value starting from, this is my value, plus 1, minus 1, plus 2, minus 2, plus 3, minus 3, plus 4, minus 4. This is the value I'm going to send it to the port 1. So I can use simply port 1. I'm going to send it to the port 1. So I have mentioned that it is, the variable name is my number. Okay. So I'm going to here. So I'm using here. I use some variable z. Okay. So this z has to be incremented. This is going to be tells you about the position, zeroth position, first position, second position, third position. That is element of array. Okay. So for that, you can use what is this that you should say. The z is, you can use unsigned. I can use unsigned character z, right? So this is my, okay. So now I'm going to use a simple for loop. So which I'm going to initialize z equal to 0. Z is less than what is how many? That is, if it is the 8 element, so you can put it as 8, which is less than 8, right? Because here the z 0 to z 7, so totally element is 8. So I'm just placing, since we have initialized as 0, so you can place it as 8 now. So z plus plus. So this is the for loop, which is going to iterate for 8 times. So you can use this. Okay. This is a simple program. So to check out that, to look into very slowly, you can use some for loop for every iteration. So that you can see the data, how closely that each and every data is changing. Okay. Let us undefined A. So I need to define the, sorry. I'm going to use another character. I'm going to, here I'm unsigned. Since my value is more than 255, I want to use it here, int is my data type, A is my variable. So now I can build the program, debug the program. So now go to the peripheral, yeah, port 1 already there. I just run it. So here you can see that the yeah, the program gets over. So only 8 value will be displayed. So here the delay is very small. So once again, I'll try to build the program. Now I'll run the program. See, here you can see my positive value, 3, minus 3, 4, minus 4. Okay. Once again, we'll try to run the program. Reset, run the program. See, 1, minus 1, 2, minus 2, 3, minus 3, 4, minus 4. So that is the value we are trying to send it to the port. 1, minus 1, 2, minus 2, 3, minus 3, 4, minus 4. This equivalent 8-bit value we are going to, equivalent 8-bit value we are passing into port 1. Okay. So for minus 1, what is the value? It should be, so I have shared the slide also previously. See, for minus 1, it is FF. For minus 2, it is FE. So that is what it is showing, FF. If you go to the simulation part also. So I'll build the program here. Just run it once again also. See, 1, FF is minus 1, FE is minus 2. So like that, 3 minus 3, 4 minus 4. This is signed number. Okay. Signed number is most significant bit. That is, bit number 7 is used for minus symbol. And the signed number ranges from, I have showed the sounds here. In even in the assembly also, we have seen for signed number, the most significant bit, if it is a 1, then it is minus. The most significant bit is 0, then it is plus. This already we have seen. So for decimal, if it is a 1, the 8-bit number is this. If it is a minus 1, the 8-bit number is this. This is what we are seeing in the port 1. So any doubt, the students can understand? So try to submit your assignments very fast. So don't delay. So finally you will be losing mark.
The link for submission.
One second.
Submission Google form link.
Button, sir.
Sir, assignment submission link.
It is there, no, in Google Classroom. That Google form I have attached. Just look into that.
Okay, fine, sir.
Okay. See, write down your assignments in pen. Okay, handwritten I required. Because copy pasting everything, I think most of the students will be giving the same file. So that is not considered. So I hope I spoke with one of the faculty also. So it is handwritten would be better, and it seems to be that you have written the assignment and you are scoring the mark. So again, I will post the attendance. You can give the attendance.